Hi friends, now we will discuss the transformer with magnetic leakage. So this is a transformer and there are two windings. Primary is connected to the supply voltage, AC supply, V1, and secondary is connected to the load. Okay, so what is magnetic leakage? So if you have given supply, primary supply to the primary winding, there will be a flux created and it will flow through the transformer core, right? Suppose let us assume there is a 100% flux. Let us assume there is a 100% flux. 95% of the flux flow like this. Okay, 95% of the flux flow like this, and remaining 5% will complete its path through air. This flux is called leakage flux. This is about only 5% of the total flux. So similarly, in the secondary winding also there is a leakage flux. Okay, this will be the leakage flux. So this leakage flux does not have any role in transferring the power from primary to secondary. Only the 95% of the flux which is flowing, which is linked to the both windings, will have a role of transferring the power from primary to secondary. But this 5% leakage flux does not have any role. Okay, this 5% leakage flux does not have any role in transferring the power. Okay, so we can say this leakage flux is the flux which is linking only one winding. Okay, which is linking only one winding. It does not link with the other windings. So because of the main flux, there will be an EMF induced, that is E1 and E2 we have already seen. Okay, but because of this leakage flux also, there will be some EMF induced. That will be, I am calling it as EL1, induced in the primary, and EL2, that will be induced in the secondary, right? So now here I have neglected the winding resistance, right? So now if you write the equation, V1 is equal to E1 plus EL1. So you take the vectors, right? So this voltage and this voltage will be equal to V1. Similarly, E2 bar is equal to, so the load voltage V2, EL2 plus V2. Okay, so here this magnetic leakage, okay, due to this magnetic leakage, there will be some voltage drop. Before, if you didn't consider this magnetic leakage and winding resistance, V1 is equal to E1, right? So, but after considering, there will be some voltage drop due to this magnetic leakage, that is EL1. So, this leakage, this magnetic leakage can be modeled as a inductance, Okay, because you can ask why it is not modeled as a resistance, because in resistance there will be some loss. But here there is no loss, only voltage drop is present. So you can model only as an inductance. Okay, so this transformer with magnetic leakage can be represented like this. So with an inductance. So in the secondary also, you can represent like this. So this circuit is equal to this circuit here. Here this magnetic leakage, because of the voltage drop occurs in the magnetic leakage, is equal to the voltage drop occurs in this inductance. Right? So here V1 and this is V2. Here it will be E1 and it will be E2. Right? So both circuits are similar. Okay, so now this EL1, okay, so if you have taken inductance here, it has some reactance. Okay, so EL1 is equal to, so I1 X1, so magnitude I am writing here, And EL2 is equal to I2 into X2. So here the current is I2, here the current is I1. So you can write like this, right? So X1 is equal to EL1 by I1, and similarly X2, the reactance is equal to EL2 by I2. And one more point. So in the previous class, we have already transferred the resistances from one side to the another side. So here, these reactances also, this X1 and X2, these reactances also can be transferred from one side to the another in the same way as resistances. So X01, this is the total equivalent reactance of the transformer referred to the primary. So X01 is equal to X1, this is already existing in the primary, plus X2 dash. This is the reactance referred to the, this is the secondary reactance referred to the primary. So that is equal to X1 plus X2 by K square, right? Similar to the resistances we have already seen in the last video. Next, so similarly, if you transfer the primary reactance to the secondary, if you transfer the primary reactance to the secondary, the total reactance, the total equivalent reactance referred to the secondary X02 is equal to X2 plus X1 dash. That is equal to X2 plus K square into X1, right? Is it clear? So now you can transfer the reactance also. If you transfer the secondary reactance to the primary, it will be multiplied by 1 by K square. And if you transfer the primary reactance to the secondary, it will be multiplied with K square. Similar way with resistances. Thank you.